Okay, fair. Okay, I know I'm a bit late to talk about this, but here it is. I want to throw my opinions out there about the new iOS 14. So Apple has been getting mixed reactions, as usual. Some people like it, some people meme it, and gotta say they come up with pretty good memes as well. And of course, it's Apple. People just love dissing Apple for whatever they do, because not gonna lie, sometimes they can come up with pretty unreasonable actions stuff, you know? So the reason why I do this video is I'm hoping to change your perspective or the way you see Apple, probably in a way that they actually deserve. So Apple has thrown in new features on the iOS 14, and some of the features are already available in Android devices for so many years now, and you already know this. But the question is, why now? Why not last year or last 2 years ago? So you can either view this in a perspective that says, you know, as simple as Apple copies Android and they have run out of ideas, or you can view this whole situation as a winning round for Android. And the reason is, Apple being a very prestigious company, it seems like they have come up to a realization that they are actually falling behind in terms of user experience. So in order for them to close the gap and provide a better experience, they decide to take some of the features that Android has and redesign them in a way that fits the whole iOS team. Although I gotta say, it is not very Apple-ish of them to do so, but they have no other options. They have to do it. They have to make iOS better for their users sooner or later. For example, they know their users want to do something else while watching a video, so they introduce picture-in-picture feature. They know their iMessage is kind of falling behind in terms of user interface if compared to WhatsApp or Telegram. So they introduce similar features that these apps have, like reply to a specific text, tagging, or getting notifications only when you're mentioned in a group. They know how chaotic their home screen can be, so, you know, with so many apps installed, so they add apps library to have it more organized. They know sometimes their user just want to unlock the phone and get, you know, the information they want, such as calendar or weather, by only glancing at the home screen. So Apple add widget features to their iOS. But again, why now? So to answer this question, you have to understand Apple is not a company that simply rush their way out to launch new features as soon as they can. And with the release of all these new features on the iOS 14, it gives the impression, at least for me, that Apple knows they're extremely late, but nevertheless, they still took their sweet time, and that's just Apple. So that's why it is understandable that they thought this is the perfect time to have these new features. And relatively speaking, when Apple's VP was asked why there isn't any built-in calculator app for iPad, here's what he explained.
You know, there's some things that we have not done because we to do it, we would want to do something really distinctly great in that space. And I think it's obviously easy to create a calculator app, but creating one that feels like, wow, this is the greatest iPad calculator app, that it felt like, I think we want to do it when we can do it really, really well. And we honestly have just haven't gotten around to doing it great.
Now, you know how perfectionist Apple is, even when they're trying to make a simple calculator app. At some point, it can sound absurd, but again, it's Apple. And about that Apple copies Android thing, just don't bother dissing Apple with that. Because when the Essential Phone, I think the first phone with notch was introduced, nobody bothers to copy the small notch. But when iPhone X was released, suddenly almost all Android phones after had the same notch design as well. And another obvious great example is the swipe up gesture that Apple introduced in their iOS. Not long after that, Android used that as well. So it doesn't matter who copies who now, it's just everyone has been copying each other. But what matters now is who can actually provide a more seamless and better experience to their users. And having said that, this whole Apple copies Android thing is actually a beginning, at least in my own opinion. So from now on, they'll actually fight each other and eventually end up with improving themselves, and it's going to get really interesting. So as of for us, whether an iPhone or Android users, we just wait. And I think the only thing that should be copied by Android is in terms of update. As you already know, the iOS 14 will support as of iPhone 6s, which was released in 2014. So Android team should really do something about it, something that makes it easier for companies to roll off new updates to their users. Okay, so What about you guys? What do you think about the new iOS 14? Do you feel like it should have been released a few years ago? Whatever it is, leave your comment down below. Thanks for watching. Hit the like button if you enjoy the content of this video, and hit the subscribe button if you enjoy the content of my channel as usual. See you next one.